Let us learn production part approval process, PPAP. Production part approval process is used in the automotive supply chain for establishing confidence in the component suppliers and their production processes. It helps manufacturers and buyers communicate and approve production designs and processes before, during and after manufacture. PPAP ensures that the processes used to manufacture parts can consistently reproduce the parts at stated production rates during routine production runs. PPAP consists of different documentation levels and each level determines the specific requirements for each element and indicates which element should be submitted to the customer. There are total 5 document submission levels and each having different document requirements. Production part approval process should submit following list of documents: design records, engineering change documents, customer engineering approval, design FMEA, process flowchart, process FMEA, control plan, MSA, dimensional analysis, material performance reviews, initial process studies, qualified laboratory documentation, ARR means appearance approval report, sample product, master sample, checking aids, records of compliance, PSW means part submission warrant. Let us go through one by one. Design records. This could be a drawing of the part. This is normally provided by the customer because they are the ones who would normally design the part and understand its end use. A print copy of the drawing or design record should be sent along with the PPAP for verification that customer and organization have a same copy of the part drawing. Engineering change documents. These include any marked or signed drawings, specifications, etc. that state or authorize the supplier to deviate or change any part of the instructions from the design record. Supplier should also include any applicable engineering permits and any extra comments that relate to deviation of the design or engineering changes. Customer engineering approval. It includes documents relating to temporary deviation and any supporting evidence of parts sent to the customer before PPAP. Design FMEA. Design failure mode and effects analysis is an application of FMEA principles but especially aimed at the design stage of the process. The basic concept of design FMEA is to understand where the product design could fail. Process flow diagrams. Process flow diagram, also known as process flow chart, shows the document and clarifies all steps required in the manufacturing of the part. It must include all the main steps in the processing of the part and also all offline activities such as handling, measuring, inspection, etc. Process FMEA. PPAP must include process FMEA that considers all possible failures of the production process for the part. When the process FMEA has been created, it becomes a living document and is maintained throughout the entire life cycle of the part. Control plan. A control plan of the process should be included in your PPAP submission. It consists of all the control parameters from incoming to dispatch stage. MSA. PPAP supplier must demonstrate their own MSA system and must record all tools and instruments used to measure or check the raw materials and finished parts that are listed in the control plan. Dimensional analysis. This will include analysis of measurements specified by the customer drawing. Material performance test. This should include a summary of all tests that have been performed on the part. The summary should document any pass or fails that have been identified. It should be signed off by the customer and the supplier to show that all tests that are required to have been done and any additional data for the tests have been submitted. Initial process studies. During the initial process study stage of PPAP, the customer needs to start performing internal studies. The supplier needs to complete any customer required studies. An SPC can be used to demonstrate the process capability. Qualified laboratory documentation. If testing is performed in a supplier's internal lab, they must provide a copy of their quality certification. The supplier should also provide documentation from a third-party testing agency or any data from the raw supplier. ARR, appearance approval report. This report needs to be included in PPAP. This produced from the appearance approval inspection process. This needs to be signed by the customer and include any other documents related to the appearance of the part. Sample product. Sample production part needs to be submitted during PPAP submission for their analysis and approval. Master sample. A master sample is needed to complete the PPAP. This sample must be signed by the customer and the supplier when they are both happy that the sample part meets all the design requirements and extra customer requirements. Checking aids. When special tools are used, they should be identified, documented and included in this section, and this should also include the calibration records of the tools and the dimensional report from the tools. Records of compliance. This is compliance record given to the customer during PPAP submission. PSW, Part Submission Warrant. PSW is a document that summarizes the whole PPAP package. It needs to include details such as part information, supplier's contact information, customer's contact information, materials reporting, reason for submission, requested submission level, submission results, declaration, explanation or comments, status.
These are the list of PPAP documents.